What up, YouTube? Spike Roy here with another video, and I'm going to answer the question, would I want a James Bond movie that is faithful to the Ian Fleming novels? I would have to say no. That is my final answer. I don't want a 007 movie that is extremely faithful to the novels or short stories by Ian Fleming, for several reasons. First of all, it is actually harder than you think it is to adapt a James Bond novel. Now, full disclosure, the only James Bond novel that I've actually read was Dr. No. Now, the movie is more or less the same as the novel, except for the ending. The movie's ending is not the same as it was in the novel, and to be honest, I would have hated the movie if the ending was the same. Sure, it would be book accurate, but I wouldn't give a fuck if the movie had a B-movie budget and didn't feature Sean Connery if it meant that that ending was changed. Thankfully, the actual Dr. No movie, they made the right call by changing the ending, so good on them. It is extremely frustrating when an adaptation carries over integral problems with the source material. Spyro reignited anyone? Anyway, most of the information that I've gathered about the James Bond novels is from Calvin Dyson, who has read every single novel, and so he's the real expert on this. But his information is really helpful for my case. According to Calvin, half the 007 novels would almost be e-cooking shows, because Ian Fleming goes into extensive detail about the food Bond eats and the taste. The same thing with wine and beer and stuff. I would imagine that would happen pretty frequently in them. That is not to say that Ian Fleming is a fucking bad writer, but that would be really difficult to translate to film. You would have to do a monologue in James Bond's head or something, or I don't know. But even if you tried to do that, you would have meandering plots and you would slow the pacing down to a crawl. What works in a novel doesn't always work in a movie. One of the short stories, which is 007 in New York, would pretty much require changing the source material into making a good movie. Another problem with adapting the James Bond novels is the version of James Bond in the novels himself, the character. Sure, I have criticized James Bond acting out of character and what I think James Bond would do, you know, giving my own insight, but I am exclusively talking about the film version of James Bond, not the James Bond in the novels. The James Bond in the novels is different. If the next movie was exactly how James Bond was in the novels, I don't think many audiences would even like the guy. I wouldn't like him. He isn't the charming hero that always gets the girl and is charismatic. He is actually kind of a dour and depressing character that can't seem to enjoy anything, really. Hell, from what I've heard, the Diamonds Are Forever novel is mostly just him complaining and bitching that he doesn't even want to do the mission he is on. That does not sound like a fun movie to watch. Actually, this is one of the reasons I hated Indiana Jones and the Dial of Destiny. Because watching a movie where the main character doesn't even want to be on the adventure on, it's just not fun. Part of what makes the 007 series so good is the ability to mix the charming with the brutal and somehow make it feel real. Like, somehow make it melt into each other so naturally. I generally prefer the Bond movies that have a perfect balance of that. The Man with the Golden Gun takes them to both the extreme, yeah. It goes to the extreme with both the charm and the brutal. Hell, James Bond is more brutal in this movie than even in the novels. A lot of people think that Roger Moore is the more lighthearted portrayal. That's not entirely true. He has a lot of harder edged moments, in both that movie and Octopussy and a few others. But I think taking in both to the extreme is kind of why I like that movie so much. It somehow feels like it was in the same vein as everything else. While Timothy Dalton is closer to the novels, I still felt he had some of that charm to the character from the previous movies. And to be fair, he's not entirely the same as the novels. He did have some good one-liners and a dry sense of humor. Also, his complaints about his job were still shit that you could identify with. He felt like he was being restricted by MI6 and is kind of a romantic hero, in the sense that he was rebelling against the established rules. Now, if there's any actor who goes all in on the brutal, it would be Daniel Craig. Even then, he is not 100% accurate to the novels. After Vesper dies in the novels, he doesn't really go out for revenge, but instead goes into more of a depression in the novels. Anyway, the reason why Daniel Craig is my least favorite is because he just doesn't really have that charm that the other actors have. He's a lot more monotone and seems to be more serious, but only because a lot of characters around that time were like that. I also don't identify as much with his struggles. To be fair, the James Bond character in the novels did quip some one-liners later on in the series. But getting back to my main point, making the character more likable was also the right call. Ian Fleming himself said that the character is not really a likable guy. On some level, he understood why the film adaptations of his work when the film adaptations of his work came, the filmmakers wanted to make his character more accessible to audiences. I also want to briefly touch on this. If the next movie was extremely accurate to the novels, then people who called the character sexist would actually have a leg to stand on, because he was actually sexist. It is pretty fucking blatant. I believe the movie version of 007 is anything but sexist. Most of the changes to the movie Casino Royale, you know, the one with Daniel Craig, were more cultural changes, because the filmmakers knew that some of that stuff would not fly in 2006. So, I've come to an interesting conclusion. The James Bond film series is at its best when it doesn't follow the novels closely. The Man with the Golden Gun and The Spy Who Loved Me are some of my favorite movies in the 007 series. And keep in mind, both those movies have almost nothing to do with the novels they're based on. That is probably for the best, considering that even fans of the novels don't really consider either one of those the best of Ian Fleming's work. Even Ian Fleming didn't like how The Man with the Golden Gun turned out. Judging from what I've heard in both those novels, I'm glad they changed both. While Diamonds Are Forever is not my favorite movie in the series, I think if it was accurate to the novel, it would have been even worse. The only exception is I would have preferred if they used the House of Death or whatever from You Only Live Twice compared to what they actually did for that movie. But even then, that is probably the only thing that I would have liked to see in that movie. Maybe the House of Death could have replaced the whole outer space or television bullshit from that movie. Now, if you do enjoy the novels, that is totally fine, but just so you know, they are tougher to adapt than you think. So, what do I want from the next Bond movie? Considering that I am drowned out from going all out brutal, I would like a Bond movie that is actually more similar to the Sean Connery and Roger Moore era of 007, in tone at least. One that perfectly mixes the charm and the brutal nature. This is why I didn't actually hate Spectre as much as many people did. Granted, it's far from my favorite movie, but it got me excited that maybe they were going to go back to that, only to do a 180 with No Time to Die, and it's like, come on, man, you're fucking killing the vibe. Am I the only one who's sick of the dark and gritty, man? If the next movie can go back to that, I will be on board. So, yeah. That's really my two cents on the matter. So anyway, I'm Spike Robot. If you like this video, you can subscribe to my channel and feel free to support me on Patreon. Anyway, see you next time on Other Freedom Jingos. Your sugar cone.